In the previous lecture, we saw the generation of the VSB modulated signal, which transmits a sideband along with the vestige of the other sideband. VSB modulation is a modulation technique that is primarily used in broadcasting and communication system. It is a compromise between the band efficiency of SSB and the ease of implementation of amplitude modulation. VSB modulated signal was generated by passing it through the VSB sideband filter. VSB sideband filter is a specially designed filter which passes the main sideband along with the vestige of the other sideband. Now, VSB modulated signal is mainly generated from the DSB SC signal. By passing the DSB SC signal through the VSB sideband filter, having a response like this, we can generate VSB modulated signal with upper sideband and the vestige of the lower sideband. And if the VSB sideband filter has a response like this, then we can generate VSB modulated signal with lower sideband and the vestige of the upper sideband. Let's see how to demodulate this VSB modulated signal. At first, you will see the block diagram for the demodulation of VSB modulated signal. And in order to demodulate this VSB modulated signal, VSB modulated signal YT and the carrier signal from the local oscillator AC cos 2pi FCT are given as inputs to the product modulator, and output of this product modulator is ZT. This ZT is passed through a low pass filter. By passing the signal ZT through a low pass filter, it will eliminate the high frequency terms, and finally, after the low pass filtration, we will get the scaled version of the message signal MT as the output. So we have extracted the message signal MT from the VSB modulated signal YT, or we have performed the demodulation of VSB modulated signal. Let's see the mathematical analysis for VSB demodulation. Let's say VSB modulated signal is equal to YT and the carrier signal from the local oscillator or CT is equal to AC cos omega CT, which can be written as AC cos 2pi FCT. Now both of the signals YT and CT are given as input to the product modulator. Output of this product modulator is ZT. So ZT can be written as YT into CT. And if we put the value of CT as AC cos 2pi FCT, then ZT can be written as ZT is equal to YT into AC cos 2pi FCT. Now, by taking the Fourier transform, this ZT can be written as capital Z of F, and YT will become capital Y of F, and this multiplication sign can be replaced by a convolution, and this cos 2pi FCT has the Fourier transform of half into del F minus FC plus del F plus FC, which will be multiplied by AC. Now, this AC by 2 is constant, and we can take this AC by 2 out of the square brackets. Then capital Z of F will look like capital Z of F is equal to AC by 2 into capital Y of F convoluted with del F minus FC plus del F plus FC. Now, if we perform the convolution with capital Y of F with del F minus FC plus del F plus FC, then it can be written as capital Y of F minus FC plus capital Y of F plus FC. Then capital Z of F can be written as AC by 2 into capital Y of F minus FC plus capital Y of F plus FC. Now the VSB modulated signal or capital Y of F can be given by AC by 2 into capital M of F minus FC plus capital M of F plus FC multiplied by filter transform function capital H of F. From here we can determine capital Y of F minus FC by replacing the frequency F as F minus FC, then capital Y of F minus FC will result in AC by 2 capital M of F minus FC minus FC plus capital M of F plus FC minus FC into capital H of F minus FC, which can be simplified as capital Y of F minus FC is equal to AC by 2 capital M of F minus 2 FC plus capital M of F into capital H of F minus FC. Similarly, we can obtain capital Y of F plus FC, which will result in AC by 2 capital M of F plus capital M of F plus 2 FC plus capital H of F plus FC. Now we can put this value of capital Y of F minus FC and capital Y of F plus FC in the equation of capital Z of F. Then capital Z of F will look like this, and we can multiply this AC by 2 in both the terms, which will become AC square by 2. And by taking this AC square by 2 common, equation of capital Z of F can be written as AC square by 2 into capital M of F minus 2 FC into capital H of F minus FC plus capital M of F into capital H of F minus FC plus M of F plus 2 FC into capital H of F plus FC plus capital M of F into capital H of F plus FC. Now this Z of F will be passed through a low pass filter, which eliminates the high frequency term. Here, capital M of F minus 2 FC into capital H of F minus FC and capital M of F plus to FC into capital H of F plus FC at the high frequency term, and by passing the signals capital Z of F through the low pass filter, this term will be removed. Then the output of the low pass filter or capital Z prime of F can be given by AC square by 2 into capital M of F into capital H of F minus FC plus capital M of F into capital H of F plus FC. From here we can take capital M of F common, and this will look like AC square by 2 into capital H of F minus FC plus capital H of F plus FC into capital M of F. Now this capital H of F plus FC plus capital H of F minus FC is constant, which is equal to K. So capital Z prime of F can be written as AC square by 2 into K into capital M of F. Now this AC square by 2 and K will introduce another constant K1. So capital Z of F will be equal to K1 into capital M of F. By taking the inverse Fourier transform, this capital Z of F will become ZT and capital M of F will become MT. So ZT is equal to K1 into MT, or we can write ZT is proportional to MT. So this K1 into F is actually our desired message signal, but it is a scaled version of the message signal and it is scaled by a value of K1. In order to modulate this message signal, it is important that the H of F plus FC plus H of F minus FC is equal to constant. Now we will see why this is equal to constant. Here H of F is the transfer function of the VSB sideband filter. Now let's look at the spectrum of the VSB sideband filter. Now the VSB sideband filter spectrum or capital H of F looks like this. Now we can obtain capital H of F plus FC by shifting capital H of F to the left along with the frequency axis by value of frequency FC, while we can obtain capital H of F minus FC by shifting the capital H of F to the right by an amount of frequency FC. Now if we combine these two response, then we can get capital H of F minus FC plus capital H of F plus FC, which has the amplitude approximately equal to 1. Hence we have proved that capital H of F plus FC plus capital H of F minus FC is equal to constant, and the value of this constant is equal to 1 from the frequency minus W to plus W. So we have obtained the demodulated message signal from the VSB FC modulated signal.
This concludes our discussion for this lecture. In the event that you have any question regarding this presentation, feel free to post them in the comment section, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.